Right, we're Mode Step, and this is our album chart show introduces.
Put on no shades and wait till yesterday. The sunlight hurts my eyes. Put on no shades and wait till yesterday. The sunlight hurts my eyes. Put on no shades and wait till yesterday. The sunlight hurts my eyes. Put on no shades and wait till yesterday.
So the tracks we play for you are Sunlight. It's about kind of at the end of the night, going out of a club and it, you know, the sun's already in the sky and yeah, that horrible feeling when you know you have to walk home. But yeah, it's trying to put a good spin on it. It's kind of, yeah, trying to write something for people who do go clubbing and something a bit anthemic. It's trying to make the night a little bit better. We called the band Mode Step kind of by accident, actually. We originally wanted to be called Mode, and we went to register our MySpace. This was in the early days, and yeah, it had been taken, and it offered Mode Step as an option, so I just thought, cool, let's go with that. And everyone just started calling us Mode Step, so I just thought, all right, if they're calling us that, we may as well just stick with it. I think the people who are flying the flag for British dubstep are kind of the original guys, Scream and Benga. I kind of feel like we represent a crossover in, you know, we've got a lot of influences from dubstep, but we never consider ourselves a dubstep band. We've been labelled with it, but, you know, there's just as much rock as there is dubstep, and there's just as much kind of influences from other stuff. Yeah, so we're not representing dubstep from the UK at all. The sunlight hurts my eyes.
Well, live, there's a lot of energy. I think that's the main thing that people take away from our live performances is just raw energy. And you know, there's a lot of technical wizardry that goes on as well, which is Josh's forte. Yeah, it's just energy is the main thing, I'd say.
Loud, loud noises,
loud,
and energy. And a lot of bass. A
lot of bass. I think we were described once as muscular, weren't we?
A few times we had that muscular.
Yeah, so
we try and keep it all to like live instruments as much as possible. So a lot of stuff going on. Yeah.
We got asked to do Live Lounge a couple of months ago, and we picked Paradise to do as our light mystery cover. It went down really well. It's the only time we performed it was on Live Lounge, and to be honest, we weren't that happy with the mix down of it that went out. So we just wanted another chance to kind of do it live for you guys to hear it properly, what it was actually meant to be like. And hopefully it'll be the B-side to our single, if Coldplay will let us. So.
Please, Coldplay, let us.
Come on, Chris. From a reach, so she ran away in her sleep. Dreamed of paradise, every time she closed her eyes. In the night, the stormy night, she closed her eyes.
Well, I was introduced to the band 6 months ago, actually, for mutual friends. And, yeah, I think you guys were looking to up the liveness of the music for guitarists. And I was like, oh, I'll play guitar. So, yeah, that's how I jumped in.
I lived with Matt for 3 years at university. It's good fun, wasn't it?
I don't remember much of
that. No, yeah, we were in a few other bands together, a few little projects, and we just jammed constantly, so we knew, like, on a musical level, we'd be able to go up there and, you know, blag it, basically, which is what we do every night. But yeah, no, it was cool to have someone that I know really well, and obviously working with my brother, it's been cool. Matt's a big Led Zepp fan. Nick, who do you love?
Yeah, well, I come from a similar background to Matt and started a lot of old rock music and 50s, 60s music. But I think it's all pretty reflected on the album, actually. It's a mashup of all our influences together, so yeah. The fans would be really surprised, actually, why they're here.
Yeah, the album's not like the singles. It has kind of quite a big, varied amount of influences. I mean, me and Tony come from more of a soul background. We're like Motown, and I'm, you know, a big Donny Hathaway and Stevie Wonder fan, so we've got kind of like melodically some of that stuff in there.
Probably not what people are expecting.
Yeah, it's not like the singles. It's not, you know, there are proper songs on there. There's stuff with no synthesizers at all on there, and we consider it more of a kind of eclectic album than just a dance album. In fact, it's definitely not a dance album. Show Me a Sign is about all the fans that are kind of stuck with us from the beginning. And yeah, there's been a lot of, you know, people saying stuff about us on the internet and this, that and the other. And, you know, it's, that one just goes out to all the fans who yeah, stuck with us, basically.
Someone raise a light up the sky above. If you're with me now, show me a sign. A light up the sky above. If you're with me now, show me a sign.
Fucking lights up.
Work really hard, and we hardly ever sleep, and we work all day, every day, pretty much all night as well, doing the little bits, the little annoying bits, the online promo, all of that stuff to try and get us as out there as we can. And for me, when I get to go on stage and perform in front of people, it kind of doesn't matter about all the rubbish stuff that we do, because just for that half an hour or 40 minutes, it's definitely worth going out there and just going crazy. The success that we've had, we've been so busy, we don't really stop, we work all the time, so it's, for us, we haven't had a lot of time for it to properly sink in. But it's been great to play all the festivals this year and just see kind of crowds turn up and sing the music and sing the lyrics back to us. It's really cool.
It's weird as well, isn't it?
This whole project for us was just an excuse to play live.
Have fun.
Have fun and enjoy ourselves, and if we can carry on doing that for the next 10 years, 5 years, a year, I'm happy.
I never thought for a second this time last year when I was working a retail job that I'd be doing that. So yeah, it's been a big shock to the system for all of us, I think.
And a massive thank you to all the fans, basically, as well.
Lights up.